الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين كاتو May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. My subject tonight inshallah concerning da'wah and would like to give the definition of da'wah. What is da'wah? When we talk about da'wah or somebody says so-and-so giving da'wah, what does it mean? Da'wah means an invitation, to invite somebody, to call somebody to something, which is can be good or bad. This is called da'wah. You can invite somebody for a meal, you invite somebody for a party, or invite somebody for class, or invite somebody to Allah, so that means you calling him to join effort, to be part of what is going on. In general, when we're talking about da'wah, that means you inviting others to the deen of Allah, the way of Allah, the teaching of al-Islam. This is what the da'wah. And da'wah is very necessary, it's very important, it has rules and regulation, it has some adab and discipline, and there is a lot to be talking about da'wah. And because the limited of time today, inshallah, we're going to try to only summarize some of these issues. And if we asking the Muslims to do da'wah, calling others to Islam, Why? Because this is a form of worship, a form of ibadah. When you invite other people to Islam, you are worshiping Allah. Salah is a form of ibadah. And da'wah also is a form of ibadah. So Allah obligated us with certain things to do. And there are certain things that became a fard upon everybody, which we call fard ayn, and there is something called fard kifaya. And the da'wah can be fard kifaya, i.e. if we have in this locality a group of the Muslims, they carry this obligation, this will free the rest of the community. Does not have to be every person in the mosque, da'iyah. But it has to be some people, a committee, a selection out of this ummah that live in this place, that their main concern is inviting and calling others to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, embracing Islam, to be part of this deen. As we say, we have to make da'wah because the order of Allah. Allah order us. He said, اُدْعُوا إِلَى سَبِيلِ رَبِّكَ بِالْحِكْمَةِ وَالْمَوْعِدَةِ الْحَسَنِ Invite them all to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah is commanding us and we need to fulfill our obligation to the best of our ability, conveying the da'wah to others. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us. In this verse, Allah is saying, Ud'u ila rabbik. So he commanded you with the da'wah and he told you the da'wah for what? What are you inviting the people to? Are you inviting them for a socialization or for fashion show or to be part of being a what you call tribalism, to be part of what it is. Ud'u ila rabbik. This is, there is no a higher goal, there is no better da'wah more than inviting people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For people to acknowledge their creator, this is the best thing, and this is the only way they can be saved. Is the people going to live in this life without acknowledging and recognizing who the creator, they are a loser. So the most important thing that we can gift it to others and give it to others is to let them know who is their creator. Ud'u ila sabili rabbika. And also this verse is telling us how is the da'wah, the mechanism, the tools of da'wah. بالحكمه والموعظه الحسنه. So when we talking to people, when we inviting people, when we calling the people, it have to be hikmah and it have to be a good approach. Hikmah, hikmah, wisdom. But what is the wisdom in the da'wah? You don't go to somebody, as example, try to run to catch the bus and you try to stop him to tell him about Allah. This is not hikmah. This is not a wisdom, okay? You don't see a person, as example, in a fight and you try to tell him about the da'wah for Allah. It has to utilize the proper time, the proper environment. You don't see somebody starving, hungry, and you start to tell him about Allah, okay? Will be hikmah and be wise that you feed him. You see, now he's not thinking about his stomach anymore. Now he's willing to hear. You see? So this is something that we have to understand. It has to be wisdom. And Allah is telling us, وَمَنْ يُؤْتَ الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوتِيَ خَيْرًا. Even, so we have to know the hikmah is something is very important for the da'wah. And وَالْمَوْعِظَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ. A good approach, good talk. Not to make the people run away, not to understand, start to warning right away by hellfire. And you understand, giving them different labels like kafirs and things like this, because the people, they don't know. So we need to be kind, nice, gentle to present the da'wah in a right way. Also, we said that we're doing da'wah because this is a means of obligation. So number one, because Allah ordered us, and this is obligation. How the obligation came? He said, وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةِ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. Let it be a nation, let it be a group among you. Okay? Selected a committee. Okay? He did not say all of you have to be given the da'wah, but at least وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةِ. Okay? مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةِ. From among you. He did not say all of you. So if we can select the most knowledgeable among us and the most smarter among us, because you are selling a product. The more how you know how to talk, the way how you present it, you can convince the person to buy. You see? Like somebody coming want to give you a vacuum cleaner. And as soon you already have a vacuum cleaner in your house. But the way how he's going to tell you about how this vacuum cleaner doesn't need a bag and doesn't take more electricity, and it has light in the front, and keep telling you how it is, the way how he present it to you, even if you did not buy, you find him say, sir, we can give it to you to use it for a whole week, no risk, free, okay? And if you don't want it, we can pick it up. So he using all the methods how to present it. So we have to select the people among ourselves who know how to communicate, how to present it, how to do these things. This is something very important. وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةِ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, let it be a group. So this is the obligation. Now, if no one among us in our locality did not do it, nobody do it, now all of us will be sinners. Okay? Like, as example, the janazah. Janazah is a fard kifaya. When your Muslim brother die, some of us have to perform the janazah. Washing the body, shroud the body, bury the body, okay? But nobody carries this obligation. Now the whole Muslim community in this area, they will be a sinner, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish them for this. So the da'wah is obligation, but it is for kifaya. We do the da'wah because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told about us about the great deal and the great blessing that involved in giving the da'wah. And we concern about earning blessings. And we concern about making the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam happy and pleased with us. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had told us, Ad-deenu nasiha. Ad-deenu nasiha. Giving advice. Okay? This is the religion. And what can be more advice and more sincerity than getting the people away from the destruction of the hellfire? Okay? Because if a person dying, not accepting Islam, he's going to hellfire. So you need to save the people. You have to develop concern in your heart for others. You don't want to see them. When you see somebody approached by a car and he's going to be get hit, you shout, say, hey, hey, watch. You see, even if you don't know this person, it's concern. So if we can imagine and get to know that the person who are not aware about Islam is exposed to the punishment of Allah, he could not be winner in this life, neither in the hereafter. It is our duty that we be sincere, and we have this ikhlas and this nasiha, and we have to be concerned. And this is what he say, concern for all human beings. You concern about the people in general, not only about the Muslims. No, we concern about every living thing, and the best thing is to give them, is for them to get to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also because we give da'wah because we want to get the reward, the blessings. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had told us, "Man dalla ala khayrin falahu mithlu fa'ili." Whosoever leads someone to a good deed, he will get the reward equal to the doer of it. So as example, if I teach somebody about salah, he doesn't know about salah. Every time the person makes salah, you get an equal reward. So you teach me Fatiha. Okay? I don't know Fatiha, I'm a new Muslim. Every time I say Fatiha, I'm getting the reward. For each letter, I'm getting blessings. Okay? You also will get the same equal reward. Why? Because you led me to this God. You see? So now can you imagine leading somebody to Islam? And this person, perhaps maybe he became a Muslim. Can you imagine every time he makes salah, every time he fasts Ramadan, every time he makes Hajj, Umrah, anything, good deed, you're going to get the same. You see? So we concern about having our scale in the day of judgment heavy so we can be safe ourselves. So we can be with the righteous and the good people in Jannah, inshallah. So we want to get reward. And is a great reward in da'wah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, by Allah, لَأَنْ يَهْدِيَ اللَّهُ بِكَ رَجُلًا وَاحِدًا خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنْ حُمُرِ النَّعَمِ. By Allah, if Allah leads one single person through your effort, okay, this much better for you than possessing the red camels. And in Arabia, in that time, when somebody having red camels, this is the best kind of camels he own, and this is like he say somebody's millionaire. Like if somebody said to you, understand that you're going to own Chevrolet dealer, as example. We don't think about da'wah in this way, you see. But only one person. Allah is not required from you that you make the whole America Muslims. One single person. How many people we know in our school? How many people we meet in our jobs? How many people they understand that we go for barbecue with them in the weekend? We know a lot of friends, they understand, and a lot of people that we socialize with. But did you ever try to make an effort to convey the da'wah? At least you try to prepare for it. It may be, you understand, going to be sometimes by a cup of coffee and donut and socializing. But you're aiming for something, you see. Establish a good relationship. And after this, maybe you understand a weekend that you're inviting him for a dinner. Or maybe understand 2-3 months later, you're inviting him to see the mosque. This is the way how we pray and general things. And maybe After this, he given him a CD about Islam. And later on, he given him a book about Islam. And now 1 year that you know the person, 2 years now, you need to come and listen, let me talk about Islam to you. What's Islam? Okay? Now, the result is not ours, okay? But the effort is ours. That means to initiate the effort and to try to talk to somebody about Islam, this is my duty and your duty. But if Allah turned his heart to Islam or not, this is not in our hands. لَيْسَ عَلَيْكَ هُدَاهُ. Even the Prophet ﷺ, Allah said, their guidance is not upon you, Muhammad. Okay? So what was the job of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ? فَذَكِّرْ إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُذَكِّرْ. Remind them. Okay? You only are a reminder, Muhammad. So our job is to convey the message. Okay? How many people you understand call your house? My name is so-and-so, company so-and-so, we try, we have a new product, and boom. Another for all. Always we get in this, you see? But these people, if everybody going to give up, they are not going to have a job. But because this is their job, calling people, try to sell them something over the phone. But if somebody say, I don't want to hear about it, you're going to tell me about it, I don't care anything about religion. Oh, this is it. We get scared, we get disappointed, we don't want to try. But if this is your job to be a salesman, somebody hang up the phone in you, you have 100 people you have to call every day. This is the way you make your money. You continue doing this. I'm sure you know what I'm talking about. Somebody try to sell you something over the phone. They don't give up their job. They don't give up effort of trying to find, and believe it or not, among maybe 50 customers, he may get one. But he has to do the job. He has to go through the list and he mark every person. Okay? So if we take Islam as a part of our mission in this life and our job, we are not going to get disappointed, especially knowing the great rewards that we're going to get. And the Prophet ﷺ said, لَأَنْ يَهْدِيَ اللَّهُ بِكَ رَجُلًا وَاحِدًا. Now, brothers and sisters, let's be honest. How long have you been Muslim? 5 years? 10 years? Born Muslim. How old are you now? 30? 40? 50? So you try to tell me that for 40 years, you could not talk to somebody, but because we did not put a target, we did not make a goal in our life. Okay, 5 years from now, I'm going to work on so-and-so. It's my neighbor who play basketball together. Okay, we are neighbors. You understand, we from the same country, we talk the same language. Okay, I'm going to work on him for 1 year, develop some kind of friendship, relationship among us. Okay, and the next year, you understand, we're going to have a dinner, and the next year, I'm going to give him a booklet. The next year, I understand, in 3 years, 5 years, now I have to come. After 4 years, I say, let's sit down and talk about it. We need to consider this, you see. We need to plan it. And you have at least 10 people that you know. From the school, from back home, you used to play in the street together, whatever it is, from where and how you know them. If you try to focus in two of them, and one day you're going to have to sit and tell him, who is your creator? If there is a creator, what this creator should look like, or what he should be able to do, what could not be, okay? And let him think. Say, okay, I know you understand, but what about, I want to leave you this book as example, you see? So, also, we have to give da'wah, because the da'wah increase our faith. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. None of you will be a true believer until he love for his brother whatever he love for himself. And some of us, they think that da'wah only to non-Muslims. Okay? How many Muslims that we know, they don't make salah? They talk the same language like you? Okay? And in Eid, they may come to the Eid prayer, and they say, okay? But you know they don't make salah. You know they don't come for Jummah. We can give them da'wah. Okay? So part of Iman, loving for others what you love for yourself. In general, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is saying, من رأى منكم منكرا فليغيره بيده. فإن لم يستطع فبلسانه، فإن لم يستطع فبقلبي، وذلك أضعف الإيمان. Whenever he says something objectionable to Islam, okay, something munkar, it is your obligation as a Muslim to change it with your hand. You could not talk against it. You could not at least hate it with your heart. There is no munkar on the earth, on the face of the earth, worse than a person saying that God has a son, or that God on the cross. This is the worst kind of sin. إيش الآية في سورة طه؟ أن دعوا للرحمن ولدا وما ينبغي للرحمن أن يتخذ. إيش بداية
قبل؟ من في السماوات والأرض لا ترى الرحمن عبدا لقد أحصاهم عددا وعدا.
نعم.
وكل ما أتي يوم القيامة فردا.
أن دعوا للرحمن قبل وأن دعوا للرحمن ولدا.
لقد قلتم شيئا عدا تكاد
السماوات. الله سبحانه وتعالى said indeed you have came with a big lie, claiming that the most beneficent has a son. And he said that this accusation or this lie is about to make the sky collapse, and that the mountain to be turned to dust. It's so serious statement that even the creation of Allah, that we assume that doesn't have feeling, like the mountains, is going to be collapse. Okay, the mountain. Okay, because it is a serious accusation, a big lie against Almighty Allah Subhanahu. As a result of this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَنْ يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never forgive for somebody to associate partner beside him, to make it equal to Allah. But he will forgive any other sin to whom he pleases. We talk sometimes people drinking, people doing this, people doing this. This is nothing compared to say that Jesus is Son of God, or that Jesus is God. So this is a munkar, and it is the obligation of the Muslims at least to talk about, to change it, to correct the people, to understand that how God can be in the cross, and how God can be dead for 3 days. Who was in the charge of the universe if God was dead? And how did God go to the grave? So if God died, who's in the charge? And if God died, so what is the difference between me and God? So God was dead, at least I'm still alive. So I'm better than God. You see, try to show them the seriousness of this matter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضٍ يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَيُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ. And this is the job of da'wah, is not only for men. Also a female Muslim woman can give da'wah. But we are not asking her to stand in the corner in the street, you see. But she can go to certain gathering, women gathering, and give them da'wah. She can invite her neighbor over her house and give her da'wah. So we don't want to mix cards now. Say, okay, how a woman can give da'wah, now she's going to take a flyers, stand in the corner and talking to a man, and after shaking hands with this and mixing with the people. No, there is a way in her privacy, and she can today over the internet, picking up the phone, talking to another sister and giving her, another female, give her da'wah. The nurse, the doctor, the person that she communicate with, she can give them da'wah. والمؤمنون والمؤمنات. Believers, male and female, are the friend of one another, loyal to one another, protector of one another, helper of one another. What is the quality? They join the good, they forbid the bad, and they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why we have to give da'wah? following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah is saying, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةً حَسَنًا. Indeed, you have the most perfect example in Rasulullah. Somebody grown his beard, why, brother? Because the Prophet has a beard. Somebody showed in his brother, why? Say, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam showed. But we don't hear somebody say, now I want to imitate the Prophet by giving da'wah. Why not? You see, if the beard is sunnah, what about da'wah? Da'wah is more important sunnah, you understand, than the beard. I'm not asking you shaving your beard, but you're growing your beard, okay, because this is the way of the Prophet. This is the tradition of the Prophet. So what about the tradition of the Prophet saving the people from hellfire? And this not only the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all the prophets, what was their job? Dawah. All their jobs. All the prophets, their job, their main duty is what? Giving dawah. So why would not try to follow the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He went to the marketplace. He went to the gathering, where is the Quraysh used to gather, chatting, saying their poetries, discussing their affairs, consultation, congress, whatever it is. He went there. He went there, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay? During the season of Hajj, people coming from different place, they still honor in the Kaaba and they come, but they have shirk. He used to go and talk to them. We have to learn techniques of da'wah, and we have to be concerned of imitation of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, following his footsteps, not only in growing the beard, and not only understand when we go to sleep on the right side. There is something else you need to extend it for the human being, because growing the beard and sleeping on the right side, you're only helping your own self. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he has this big heart for all mankind, to such a degree that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, فَلَعَنْ لَكَ بَاخِعُ النَّفْسَكَ عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمْ إِنْ لَمْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِهَذَا الْحَدِيثِ أَسَفًا. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was so concerned for the non-believers, and he wants them to accept the Islam, to such a degree that he was sad and grieved. And Allah said, what, you're going to kill yourself for them? You became so sad, you're so concerned, as if you're about dying for them, you understand? You can see how big a heart the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had concerning about the people becoming Muslims. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الرَّسُولِ بَلِّغْ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ. O Messenger, convey what been given to you, what been revealed to you from your Lord. He said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِيِّ إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ شَاهِدًا وَمُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا وَدَاعِيًا إِلَى اللَّهِ بِإِذْنِي وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا. This is the job of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said with bishara, with the warning, with the da'wah, okay? And to give the glad tidings and to warn the people. So this is the job of the Prophet, da'in. To what? To Allah. Not to Arabia, not to the culture, not to anything, da'in ila Allah. By the permission of Allah, by the order of Allah and the direction of Allah. Okay? Ya ayyuha an-nabi, sallallahu inna arsalnaka shahidan, witness against him, وَمُبَشِّرًا, to give the glad tidings, وَنَذِيرًا, and to warn them, and what, giving da'wah, okay? And سِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا, that's the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the guidance and the light that we give it. Now, why we give da'wah? Continuation of Islam. Continuation of Islam. Because if we do not give da'wah, this is the end of the Islam. If nobody going to teach, if nobody going to preach, if nobody going to correct, if nobody going to advise, if nobody going to give the da'wah, so Islam going to stop here. This coming generation, how is it going to know about Islam? You see? So if you want Islam to continue, you have to give da'wah. You have to move it from a place to place. You need it like the seed. The farmer, after the harvest, they did not take all the grains and ground it and make flour. You see? Otherwise, what's going to happen next year? No flour, no beads, no grains, but the some put aside for plantation. So if you don't have the seed and continue the harvest and growing, after this, this kind of fruit is going to end. So it always it have to be a seed planted and keep planting and giving it water and let it grow and the fruits is come. So continuation of an Islam, it depend on the da'wah and transfer the information to others. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had told us in Allah la yaqbidu al-ilm intiza'an yantazi'u min al-nas. ولكن يقبض العلم بقدر العلماء. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't roll out the religion and the knowledge by snatching it away from the people. But Allah will cause the end of this knowledge by the death of the scholars. You see? So it's not that means the scholar, he died, nobody else to convey the da'wah, nobody else to teach. So this will be seizing the knowledge. So if we want the way of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the way of Allah and the teaching of Allah continuing going from country to country and from town to town and from generation to generation, we have to take it out of the mosque. We have to take it out of the house. We have to teach it to our wives, to our children, and we have even to advise them and let them know that to pass it to the other generation. And we need to take it outside also to the other people. Now, when we give da'wah, this it make the environment of an Islam. We create an environment, the right environment for us. So if you live in a corrupted environment, and you are not trying to fix it, that this evil is going to grow more and more and more. So now when you give da'wah, even one person, okay, now this will be less even. Now these two people will give da'wah to somebody else. So we need to change the environment. It's not by a gun, it's not by a sword, it's a word, nothing else. Especially living in a country that tell you freedom of speech. Nobody's stopping you to talk, okay? And he can see all other people, all other religions, they giving da'wah. They even come and knocking in your door. I'm sure some of you got some of this Jehovah Witness or whatever they are, they come and they concern about telling you something about Isa. We want to tell you about Jesus. We want to tell you about this. We want to tell you about this. Even it doesn't know, okay, they try to give you something, give you a booklet or something like this. You see, this is something that we have to be doing this. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us, مثل القائم في حدود الله والواقع فيها كمثل قوم استهموا على سفينة. Only for the sake of the time, this is more important than dinner. You see, I will take mine to go and you can take your time and eat it, okay? But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gives very good example, brothers. And pay attention to it. He says, people want to go on a journey. So they went and they rent a ship. Okay, a big boat. What you call this yacht or when they go in
cruise.
Okay, so they rent the whole ship. Now some people in the upper part and some people in the lower part. Okay, but the other ships, they're not ours today. You have everything up and down, everything. You have bathroom, you have kitchen, you have everything. Okay. But the old days, some people down, some people up. So those people who in the bottom part, anytime they want water, they have to go up, take the steps, go up on the roof or the deck or whatever you call it, and throw the bucket in the water, get the water, go downstairs, okay? So they say, what about if we go this is our shell downstairs, the basement of the shell. Instead of going up and down, getting water, what this is our share, so let's make a hole, okay? let's have a hole, and every time we want to get water, we get it right away, directly. You see, this is the way of the thing. So the Prophet ﷺ said, if the people upstairs, leave them do this, what's going to happen? Sink. Who's going to drown? The one up or the one down? All of them going to drown. You see? So what is this telling you? That when there is a part of the community doing corruption, the rest of the community is not doing something about correcting this corruption. You see? The whole people going to be drowning. Nowadays, most the people are drowning. We are not drowning in water. We are drowning in sin. And as a result of this, we have problems. Earthquake, fire taking the forest, we taking AIDS, we're talking about sickness and illness that we never heard about it. So the human being in general nowadays, they are sinking. But not in the water. They are sinking and they're still alive. They suffer. Because when these people sink in the water, maybe half an hour, whatever, they say, they die. But can you imagine somebody living, suffering? This is worse. Okay? So you can see what's happening nowadays. So by giving da'wah, the more da'wah that we give, the more that we changing the environment, changing the people by the will of Allah, and this will be much easier on us to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْقُرَىٰ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقُوا لَفَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ بَرَكَةٍ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. If the people of the town, they believe and have taqwa, they believe and do righteous deed, we open a blessings on them from the skies and from the ground. But when the people are not believing, they are not doing the right thing, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send wrath on them, Allah send punishment on them. All these things, my dear respected brothers and sisters, to encourage you to start thinking about being a da'iyah. Okay? But more, there is many, many reasons why you should be giving da'wah. Like I said, it doesn't happen overnight. It's not because you talk to somebody that he's going to be a Muslim. But at least you need to start targeting somebody to give him da'wah, to talk to him, and you never know what can be the result. We also give da'wah because we want to get their happiness. And we want to be progress and profitable. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. So all mankind are losers, save those people. So if you don't want to be a loser, you want to be a winner, you have to do what? You have to do four things, not one of the four. You see? If you want to be out of losing, you have to do what? Four out of four, not one out of four. We understand this? Allah didn't say, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَوْ Allah didn't say, except those who believe, or do righteous deed, or no. But Allah made the quality to be four. Now you make the four, now you get the success in this life and in the hereafter. One of them is what? وَتَوَاسَوْ بِالْحَقِّ. Haqq, the truth. What can be فَمَاذَا بَعْدَ الْحَقِّ إِلَّا الضَّلَالِ. What can be more true and reality than Islam? The Book of Allah, the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah is saying, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Whosoever take any other religion different from Islam is not going to be accepted from him. And here, in the hereafter, he'll be among the losers. So Al-Haqq and the truth is in Islam. And there is no other true religion on the earth under the sun today except Al-Islam. Everything else is fabrication or been adding and deleting, so you could not call it the way to Allah. So the only way to Allah is in Islam. So you supposed to make wasiyah, recommendation, inviting others to the haqq. But listen to the end now. Say what? وتواصل بالصبر. You have to have patience. Da'wah. You may feel embarrassed. Somebody shut the door in your face. Some said you don't come here on my door anymore. Or somebody say I don't care. So if you don't have sabr, you say, oh man, no, I'm so and so, I'm doctor so and so. I have to go to these people. They slap the door in my face. Subhanallah. Think about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How much is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam been disturbed and annoyed and عذب and everything for the sake of Allah for that da'wah? Why? They used to love the Prophet and respect the Prophet before he became the messenger of Allah. The moment he started to tell them, I'm the messenger of Allah, even his family. Huh? Abu Lahab. Tabba. You see? So, if you have to have sabr when you give da'wah, and you have to see these things happening to you, and you be patient, and because you have concern and love, you don't want these people to die without Islam, you will go again, try somebody else. That's the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When the people of Mecca, they did not respond, he didn't say, okay, let's stop this business. He went to Ta'if. It didn't work in Ta'if, he came back to Mecca. In Mecca didn't work, he went to Medina. But finally, look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it work. Become Muslim Ummah, he come back to Mecca, he took over, became Khilafah, became all these things, you see. But it is the job that we need to do, the result is not ours. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he knows which heart to answer to this da'wah or not. But we need to do it, because we the one who need to strengthen our iman. We give da'wah because we want to revive the nation, the whole human being. Because the one who lives with Islam, he's dead, even if he's walking. Alright? All the people are dead. And all the people are in darkness until they see Islam. Until they get to know that La ilaha illallah. So our concern that for mankind, because we live with a big heart, like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he has a big heart, we try to have a big heart, we concern about everybody, we want them to come out of the darkness. And we want them to be alive while they are living in this life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying in the Quran, أَوَمَنْ كَانَ مَيْتًا فَأَحْيَيْنَاهُ وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ. Is it the one that who used to be dead and we revive him? And we give him light that he can see? What does this mean? Like Umar ibn al-Khattab, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, all the Sahaba, they were dead in a sense, they don't know Allah. So Allah says they used to be dead, but we revive them, that means we give them life. How? They get to know who's Allah. So until you get to know Allah, you are dead. Alaykum salam. Until you get to know Allah, you are living in darkness. What about the PhD in chemistry? What are you talking about? You're still living in darkness. Okay? You're still living in darkness. Also, we won't save mankind from the zulm and the oppression that fallen in them. Because when the people living by a man-made laws, okay, this is zulm, this is oppression. Because no man can legislate for a man. You have to be superior than me to be able to make a law for me. You see? Otherwise you do it by force. This is the difference. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is superior over all of us in knowledge, in wisdom, in everything. As a result of this, Allah is the only one has the right to legislate. So by giving the people Islam, you are freeing them from the oppression that fall in them and the zulm of mankind. Doesn't matter if they are white or black, they are whatever their position. So until the people get to see Islam and live Islam, they live in under a oppression. And it is the duty of the Muslim to try to help to relieve the people. Also, we need to relieve the people from slavery. Slavery is not ended by Abraham Lincoln, okay? Slavery is not only was for the black people. Human beings nowadays, they are living in slavery, okay? They enslave themselves, or they've been enslaved by other men, making them doing things or saying things or living different life from what is supposed to be. And like for those who heard the khutbah al-Jum'ah, we heard what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying. تعس عبد الدرهم تعس عبد القطيفة تعس عبد الخميسة تعس وانتكس. So there is a slavery for objects, for things in this life. So the person who lives only for the dollar and for the dinar, he became a slave of the dollar. Okay? All what he cares is dollar. A person who can be enslaved by different things, and also can be enslaved by constitution and government and all these things. So you want to free mankind. How you want to free mankind? There's no way unless they have Islam. We want to be the best nation, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had made it for us, and he said, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. You are the best nation. How the ummah can be the best nation? Only because تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. So when we are not giving da'wah, when we are not changing the munkar, we could not continue to be the best nation. So if you want to be part of the best nation, and this for ummah to remain the best nation, you have to know what is the quality and work on this quality. كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ. So now when the Muslims stop giving the da'wah, okay, they could not. When they stop changing the evil, when they stop joining the good deed, now they could not continue to have the khair ummah. Okay, I know that the subject can be longer than this, and you're still rushing me for having dinner, but maybe we can continue another time. But last things that I want to get it here, we give da'wah so we can be excused or saved from the punishment of Allah if it falls in the people. Because when the people involved in the haram, committing the sin day and night, and like I said, nothing can be more haram and more terrible than associating partner beside Allah. Okay? So when you give in the da'wah, you be excused, at least you have excuse with Allah. I try to change. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا كَانَ رَبُّكَ مُهْلِكَ الْقُرَى بِظُلْمٍ وَأَهْلُهَا مُصْلِحُونَ. Never Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punish a community while the people are مُصْلِحُون, not صَالِحُون, not unrighteous. It's not enough for you to be good in yourself, but for you to try to correct the others. You see? So Allah never sends a punishment on a people who try to correct. But when we stop making correction and giving da'wah to others, now it can fall in us. So it's very important for us, and for us to change the munkar to the best of our ability, and use the hikmah and the wisdom, and to carry the job of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to be a continuation for this. Would you please ask? Inshallah, I see is it blinking?
Yeah, it's about 3 minutes more.
How many?
3 minutes.
Awesome, 3 minutes. Okay, and I want to propose something to you here, brothers, tonight, inshallah, since we're talking about da'wah, and I happen to have something here with me. Not every one of us have the ability to talk. Not everybody has the knowledge. Not everybody has the language, okay? But at least you can make some effort, okay? At least you can make some effort. Some friends that you know, some people, you can pass them a CD, a DVD, a flyer, a booklet. This e-book about Islam for non-Muslims is going to be read also by Muslims, okay? This, as example, a booklet, all right, which you can give it to a non-Muslims. And this what you may call it a peaceful da'wah or a quiet da'wah, or for somebody who's shy, he doesn't know how to give da'wah. We can establish a friendly relationship, cup of coffee, piece of donut. Next week, you understand, Hello, how you doing? Good morning. Maybe months later, you understand, I have something, you understand, I would like you to read. Sometimes you meet people, you buy them a Coke, okay? They say. So this will be something, like I say, a quiet piece of da'wah that you're telling him, this is what I believe, this is what I'm asking you to be, and you give them this pulpit. Alhamdulillah, Allah had helped me and guided me and assisted me. I had published or reprint 20,000 copies of this booklet. I just get it last week. I'm inviting you that you be part of this da'wah. For each one of you, you understand, can get at least a 50 copy. And don't tell me you don't know a 50 people. Okay? You know only 10 people? Okay. Give it to 10 people. What about the 40 copies? Once in your lifetime, try to taste the sunnah of the Prophet. How did the Prophet went through a lot because the da'wah? Stands there in the corner. Good morning. I have something for you about this time. Sir, ma'am, good morning. How are you today? Would you like listening? Jazakumullah khairan. May Allah reward you. And we're going to close here. I'm sorry, I'm not going to entertain any question because the brother insisted that we have to eat before I leave. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Thank you.
Love.